I'm here interviewing my friends right now, and a lot of them haven't seen me since Wimbledon.
Well, if you're a tennis fan, she needs no introduction. Bethanie Mattek-Sands has won multiple Grand Slam titles in women's doubles and mixed doubles and Olympic gold, and took on the role of correspondent for just about everybody, it seemed, at this year's U.S. Open. And she even once let us hold her Olympic gold medal. You did not let us bite it, and so it's one of the many reasons why we love you. Bethanie is joining us this morning. Bethanie and her husband are based here in Arizona, and we're so glad to see you. It was so fun to see you doing those interviews during the U.S. Open. Really talking with your friends.
Yeah,
right?
Actually it was. I wanted to really get kind of fans a view behind the scenes, just with all the friends that I compete against and that I've gotten to know over the years. And to me, tennis is such an exciting game, and I feel like it was kind of missing that piece. So yeah, like you said, I was kind of working for everybody. It was a lot of fun. I probably was more busy doing TV stuff than I was when I was actually playing. But I don't want everyone to worry. I am coming back. I am going to be playing.
Yes.
So it's going to take a few more months. Mm-hmm. I'm actually home for a couple months doing rehab, training, and all that. But the plan is end of January is Australian Open, one of the biggest tournaments for us.
Yeah.
And it's a pretty quick goal. That would be 6 months to after my injury.
From Wimbledon. Uh-huh.
Yeah. So that's the incentive. That's the goal.
So to discuss this injury, I mean, it just a devastating moment in your career. Not only painful and terrifying, but also kind of at the height of how things were going so well for you and Lucy, your women's doubles partner. So at that moment in time, I imagine that you thought your career was over.
Well, it was okay. So in the moment, I obviously felt a lot of pain.
Yeah.
I actually haven't watched the video. I lived it, so I feel like, okay, I don't need to relive it. But when I went down, felt a lot of pain. I kind of made the mistake of looking at my leg, and that's where I kind of panicked. Like, the kneecap was obviously dislocated. It was up in my quad. I didn't know if it was broken. I didn't know if it was dislocated. So I kind of was in panic mode there a little bit. I mean, to think too far in the future, I wasn't really doing that. I was really just focused on not letting anyone straighten my leg in the middle of Wimbledon,
right,
in the middle of the court. And I actually asked, my husband came on the court, and I actually asked him how bad it was, first of all. But then I asked him if I was going to walk off the court. And he was like, no, you're going to be helped off the court.
And I can't imagine what he was feeling. And he's here right there and getting some video. And I mean, what an awful moment for him as well. I mean, to see the love of your life out there and writhing in pain and not knowing what to do next. And a lot of criticism came in about the amount of time you were out there. But I guess on the back end, maybe that was to protect your injury.
I think, well, one of the things is tennis isn't really used to these injuries. When you watch football, they have the golf carts on the side.
Yeah.
Like everyone's prepared, you know, for some of these guys to go down and not be able to get up. Most times when you're playing tennis, you might have an ankle sprain, but a lot of times it's, you know, an ongoing injury. It's something that, you know, a player just can't continue and they're able to walk off.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, it's tough to say that I'm maybe one of the only injuries that has been so dramatic. And in the middle of a match, and on TV, so
you had to do it in a big way, didn't you?
I did feel like I was out there forever, but for me, it was just I was really focused on somebody not straightening my leg. Like I was just having all these bad images of these war movies where like they're in the middle of the battlefield and someone's straightening their leg, and I'm just like, okay, like just get me to a hospital.
Right. Yeah. I'm not in Saving Private Ryan right now. you've been sharing video of your rehab. You've been hitting the balls. You were hitting the balls out the U.S. Open. You've got to be getting incredible support from your fans as they follow you on this journey.
It's been amazing, actually, all the support I've gotten, whether it's through my social media, my Instagram, my Snapchat, Facebook, emails, the amount. I don't even think I've been able to respond to everyone yet. Like, that's why I've been trying to put everything out on video and keep everyone updated with how I'm doing, because really the support's been amazing. And it's interesting because a lot of people are kind of telling me their stories of, you know, their injuries, their recoveries, whether it's been a few months or a few weeks or years. And they're like, you know, you've really inspired me to, you know, get out there and move around. And that's what I love to hear. And it's inspiring for me to keep going, you know, because a lot of this is, you know, keeping a positive attitude no matter what your circumstances are. And I'm a big believer in that.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I had the opportunity where, like you said, I had a lot of momentum in my career. I was playing the best tennis ever. I was going for records. You know, Wimbledon's the only Grand Slam that my partner and I don't own. So you know, it was an easy opportunity for me to say, like, woe is me, kind of, and feel and kind of dig myself in a hole and go home. And I decided not to, because I think, you know, there's plenty of opportunity out there outside of tennis, but I knew I was going to be back. So, you know, it's attitude.
And she will be back, and we'll be cheering on your progress all along, and cannot wait to see you hit the court again. Thank you so much for visiting us.
Of course, anytime.
We're your biggest fans, so please come back. Thanks, Bethanie.